I didn't leave it in the alcove. No, she hasn't. It gave me a key. And released doggies. Oh, damn it. Another crystal key. Okay. Good to know. Now we can get through that last door. I figure out what the hell is going on with that thing. It won't let us through. Bless spell expired. Prayer? You already have it. How about protection from evil then? Yes. So is the... It's still there. Oh, it cast prayer on us, too. That's good to know. Now we need to head back through this very dangerous way. Volley of spells, etc. Through here. Yeah, still something going on there. Is it through here? Yes. Third. Crystal key. Unless I messed something up. I'm afraid I missed... What if I messed something up by throwing that shield through there? I don't know. Be ready for anything. Don't throw the key at the lock. Oh, we did not have haste. We need haste. We need haste. Definitely don't have haste on. Oh, Jesus. Oh, jeez. What'd I do? I cast a spell. I'm an idiot. Prayer. Probably more of them. Hi, stragglers. I knew there was at least one arrow down this way. We can finally start moving in here. That's good news. Oh! Ooh, Caramon, level 13. Total of 77 points at this time. Oh, I don't think I should mess with you. At least not before I save the game. It does not look friendly. That's the only thing in the room, apparently. Unless there's some hidden switches. Everyone else is fine. Mm-hmm. Okay. to drop a companion. I need a bigger window. Well, too late for that. Okay. Thanks for that. I needed that. Am I supposed to do something here? That thing electrocuted us. Do I use morning's light on it? I don't know. Well, Amethyst is unconscious. Twenty-two hours. Wow. So what do we do with you? Where's haste? Why don't you memorize haste? Isn't haste third level? Why didn't she memorize it? That is weird. Did I click something and we woke up prematurely? We have it now. What are we supposed to do with this? Destroy it? Still rebounded and hurt us. Death spell? Didn't dispel that magic. Detect magic. Hmm. to do with that. I'm just going to restore because I wasted a lot of spells there. So, third crystal key. And, so, I have this thing that kills us, but I don't know what it's there for. If we touch it, it kills us. And we have this area we simply cannot go past. And we have this hidden door. So, I don't know. And this area down here is the fountain. I don't see anything else. But maybe we could find a switch for that hidden door? I mean, what was the sense of going in here? For a switch. Okay, this is water. I was trying to use incense on water. I didn't realize it was water. Even though I know I read it out loud, I wasn't. I was just reading, not absorbing. If that makes any sense. I don't know how we get in there. Oh, now we can get in here. Maybe by drinking from those fountains? Possibly? Or just by touching the death thing first. I'm not even sure. The death thing on the wall, whatever the hell it is. So... Deck magic? For this stuff? Staff of life. But it's not magical. Okay, that's the thing we threw through there. So we got that back. I was afraid I lost it. And one of our own arrows, I'm sure. Okay, so we got that staff. Really, it's not magical. Staff of Life. Okay. Maybe we use that on that shadow. Maybe life destroys death. Something like that. Seems like a classic D&D type of thing to have going on. Okay, that's what we found here is the Staff of Life. So I'm glad we were able to get through here. Death Knights. Somewhere. Where is it again? In here, right? I think. No. 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 Down here. this. Alright. Saving again. I don't know what's going to do to us this time. So maybe I'm supposed to wield this? Well, I don't know if I can wield it. I hacked. Ooh. We destroyed it. Oh, we lost this. Thus we lost the staff of life, didn't we? What did that do? Did that open up this area? Oh, you know what? I forgot to start my timer again because I stopped because I was wandering around and thinking of things. Ooh, really? Really? This might be the end. It might be the end, guys. The end? Let me time stop. Time stop. Here we go. There's more. Oh, I've been here, haven't I? The door seems to be missing a piece. This? No. I don't want that was him or no. Oh, the sun thing, maybe. Where do we put that thing? There we go. Oh my! Welcome, fabled heroes of Waterdeep. Is my allowing you to live to see the conquest of this city not enough for you? I hired you fools to distract the Quellen and actually think you would defeat him. Perhaps age has finally taken its toll on that old fool. I think age took its toll on you as well. Now that Myth Drannor's last protector and guardian is dead, I may take what I have coveted for so long. You do not know the power in which you intend to challenge. Do you actually think you could take on a god? Take them! Well, I can defeat all this stuff at my leisure. Right up its butt. Time stop expired. Oh, wow. That's it? These bosses are so easy. My friends, you have done it. You have saved Myth Drannor and thus the world from the wrath of this dark power. As we speak, other powers are at work to ensure that this vile entity shall never wreak his havoc again in this plane of existence. If the Dark God had any more time, there is no telling how many of his shadow creatures would have come through the gate. Do not fret over the death of Aquellen. His task is done here. It is time for the living to protect what is right and just. Are we missing music? Well met, heroes. Let us be the first to congratulate and thank you for what you have done here today for all life. I don't seem to be doing anything here. For your courageous and valiant deeds, we, the Knights of Myth Drannor, offer you membership into our company. Who knows, perhaps this is the first step to rebuilding Myth Drannor, the symbol of peace and harmony from a time long past. I don't know what's going on with the music. I'm sure there's supposed to be some kind of music. Do we hit start or something? Start? I don't know why that did that. So you know what I'm gonna do? We missed out on some of the music. I don't know why this just... I never had to click start there before. But what I'm going to do next... Well, right after this. I'm just gonna end the Knights of Myth Drannor. Cool. We are victorious. Without commentary, I'm gonna play the ending through... So you guys get to hear the music, anyway. So is there anything else? Chops your das. Okay. Well, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. No credits or anything like that? Of the development team or anything. But I'm going to be playing that part over and without commentary. So the LP will end that way. So I'm going to say goodbye now. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Finally finished the Eye of the Beholder trilogy. And be going on to new and, well, at least as far as this game, better games. I did enjoy it. The bosses were really easy. The hardest part for me was, I'd say the hardest part was with the earth elementals and the pit traps. That seemed to be the hardest part. The hardest enemies to battle seemed to be those, I forget what those were. Those things that ate our weapons. They weren't black puddings. It was something else. Those were tough, not only because they ate our weapons, but because they had severe damage reduction. I mean, we were doing like only like 4 or 5, 6 points of damage or something like that against them. They were tough. And the underwater level was tricky. Tough in a way, but mostly just tricky as far as the environment. I'm glad I had stored up all those healing potions, because that was the only way we could heal anybody. So, yeah, I'm sorry the music cut out. I guess we missed a few scenes. That would have been nice, the scene with Lathander when he found Dao Zimmer. I'm sure there was some music. I guess I should have realized sooner that no music was playing. And when we go through the special area where the heroes feast, the Hall of Heroes, I guess you would call it. I'm sure there's some little musical ditty that plays there as well. I don't know why this Munt emulator decided to decide that we need to press start on it. Because I've never pressed stop or start. Start. I did not click that, so I don't know. So anyway, yeah, it wasn't as good as the other Eye of the Beholders. I actually think I did enjoy both of them. I think as far as I think a lot of people seem to enjoy the second one. I mean, I've played them so long ago, but I have more fond memories of the first one, believe it or not, I guess because it was not so much groundbreaking because Dungeon Master came before it, but I don't know. I like the teleporters and such. I don't seem to remember as much about Eye of the Beholder 2. I remember Dragor. He was a pain in the butt. I died many times, and I think I only kept in two battles or something like that. One with me dying and one with me persevering. He was tough, especially because he wasn't very predictable with the dance and stuff. Sometimes he would move, you know, across next to you, and sometimes he'd move forward to the side of you, so it was kind of tough that way. But, you two had more of a story, and you had a neat, NPC by the name of Keldon Blackmore, whatever his name is. You meet him in the beginning of the game. You knew the guy in the beginning was a shady character. I mean, he looked like death. And, you know, he had raggedy pointy fingernails. His skin was like he was a corpse, and he looked evil. He had evil eyes, he had a tattered robe. I mean, the guy was basically a specter floating around telling us, hey, can you go get this artifact from this lich, because it'll help the city of Faerûn. And no. You knew that wasn't what it was going to be, but somehow our heroes fall for it. You know, especially the mage Amethyst is supposed to be intelligent. She would not fall for that stuff. And wouldn't that set off the paladin? Wouldn't that set off Gold Moon's, you know, hackles and stuff? Because he's dreadfully evil, you know, even though she isn't actively casting Detect Evil. I think they, you know, I can't speak for second edition, but I think Detect Evil, isn't that a passive skill of paladins in 3rd edition in 3.5? I can't speak for 2nd edition, though. Who knows? It might not have been. You know, I don't really know. I don't have a lot of luck looking up 2nd edition rules either on the internet. It always seems to find, you know, the other editions. But there are people still out there playing 2nd edition, believe it or not. So, yeah, I'm going to stop blabbering about those. My semi, I wouldn't call it a review, but what I think of Eye of the Beholder 3. Either way, just not hold up to the first two. It's Westwood Associates, Westwood Studios is where it's at. And SSI's own development team, sadly, at least in this instance, could not match Westwood. I miss Westwood. They came out with a lot of great games. They're really arguably best known for the Command & Conquer series. But yeah, Eye of the Beholder, 1 and 2, Lands of Lore trilogy, as well as Dungeons & Dragons, Heroes of the Eternal Sun. Oh boy, for the Sega Genesis, it's like really rare. This is pretty much probably the only Western RPG on a console at that time period. Pretty awesome. I'd love to be able to play that someday. Hopefully soon. Because it's a cross between, it looks like Ultima 6 or 7. On the, I'm blabbering again. But I digress. Yeah, it looks like Ultima 6 or 7 in the outside areas, I believe, and the top-down view, the way they look like that, and it looks like basically Eye of the Beholder when you get into the, you know, dungeon areas. There is even those Flynns that you fight in the first Eye of the Beholder are in. It's that exact character model, from what I can see. They're in Warriors of the Eternal Sun. Anyway, yeah, that's my basic review of that. of Eye of the Beholder 3. And, yeah, stay tuned. Hope to see you guys in another Let's Play, and stay tuned for the intro with music sans commentary. Thanks for watching, and always seek adventure.